Hello friends, in this video I'm going to discuss some more problems on curve tracing when equation of curve is given in Cartesian form. In this video I'm going to discuss when equation of the curve is of the form y square is equal to fx. In my previous videos I have discussed the curve equation in the form of y is equal to fx. Now in this video, I'm going to discuss how to trace a curve when equation of curve is in this form. Y square is equal to fx. Let us consider this example. Y square into 2a minus x is equal to x cube. This curve is called cissoid curve. Okay, now let us trace this curve. First, this can be written as 2ay square minus xy square minus x cube is equal to 0. This equation can be written like this. Now first step is symmetry. Now since power of y in the equation is even everywhere, here 2, therefore this curve is symmetric with respect to x-axis. Symmetric with respect to x-axis. Okay. Now since power of x is not even, here it is 1, it is 3, not even everywhere, therefore it is not symmetric with respect to y-axis. This is symmetric with respect to x-axis. That means it is enough to sketch the curve above x-axis, then take its reflection in the x-axis. Okay. Now, second is origin. On taking x to be 0 and y to be 0, equation is satisfied. Therefore, it passes through origin. Passes through origin. Now, tangent at origin. Now, we have to find tangent at origin. Now, tangent at origin is equating to 0, lowest degree term. Here it is degree is 2. Here 3, that means 2ay square is equal to 0, that is y is equal to 0, that is x-axis is the tangent at the origin. X-axis is the tangent at the origin. Okay, next is intersection with coordinate axis. Intersection with coordinate axis. Now when x is 0, this implies y is 0, and when y is 0, this implies x is 0. That means 0, 0 is the only point of intersection. Okay. Next, we have to find the asymptotes. Now, asymptotes parallel to y-axis is given by equating to 0 coefficient of highest power of y. Okay, that is 2a minus x is equal to 0. That is x is equal to 2a. This is an asymptote parallel to y-axis. Okay, also equation asymptote parallel to x-axis. Highest coefficient is 3. And coefficient is 1. Therefore, no asymptote parallel to x-axis. No asymptote is parallel to x-axis. Okay. Next, I have to find the region where curve lies and where curve does not lie. Okay. Next step is region. Okay. Now, y square is equal to x cube by 2a minus x. Okay, now since LHS is positive, this implies RHS is also positive. Now, RHS is positive if both numerator and denominator are positive or if both numerator and denominator are negative. Okay, we have two possibilities. First is, both numerator and denominator are positive. This implies x is greater than 0 minus x is greater than minus 2a. That is x is greater than 0 and x is less than 2a. that is x lies between 0 and 2a. This is the region. And second thing is x cube is greater less than 0 and 2a minus x is less than 0. This gives x is less than 0 and this gives minus x is less than minus 2a. That is x is greater than 2a and x is less than 0. Together, it has no solution. It is not possible if x is less than 0 and x is greater than 2a also. Therefore, region is, therefore curve lies between, therefore curve lies between 0 and 2a. That is 0 less than x less than 2a. This is the region. Next is to find the critical values. Next, we have to find the critical values where the function is increasing and where it is decreasing function. Okay, for this we have to find the derivative. Now y is x cube upon 2a minus x square root. Okay, now we have to find its derivative. Dy by dx is equal to 1 by 2 x cube 2a minus x minus 1 by 2. Now applying the quotient rule of differentiation, this is 2a minus x whole square 2a minus x into 3x square minus x cube minus 1. Okay, now we have to simplify this. This is equal to, now this is equal to 1 by 2 into x cube by 2a minus x minus 1 by 2 into 6ax square minus 3x cube plus x cube by 2a minus x whole square. Now this is 1 by 2 into 2a minus x by x cube. Okay, and this is 6ax square minus 2x cube by 2a minus x whole square. Now, this 2 get cancelled out. This is 2a minus x by x cube and this is 3ax square minus x cube upon 2a minus x whole square. Okay, now this can be written as 3a minus x. Now this is equal to 3a minus x into x square by 2a minus x whole square into square root of 2a minus x by x into square root of x. I can write this in this form. This x, 1x will get cancelled out. This is 3a minus x into x by square root of x into 2a minus x 2 minus 1 by 2. That is 3a minus x into x by square root of x into 2a minus x power 3 by 2. Now dy by dx is positive if this is positive. That is, if 3a minus x is greater than 0 and x is greater than 0, or 3a minus x is less than 0 and x is less than 0. Okay, now 1 gives minus x is greater than minus 3a and x is greater than 0. That is, x is less than 3a and x is greater than 0. That is, x lies between 0 and 3a. This is one solution. And second gives minus x is less than minus 3a and x is less than 0. That is, x is greater than 3a and x is less than 0. Together has no solution. It is not possible that x is less than 0 also and x is greater than 3a also. Therefore, the solution is this. Y is increasing if x lies between 0 and 3a. Okay. Therefore, y is strictly increasing in the interval 0, 3, but since region of the curve is 0, 2, therefore y is strictly increasing in the interval 0, 2. Okay, since region is this in the interval 0, 2. Okay, therefore y is strictly increasing in this interval. Now we can plot our graph. Therefore curve is of the form, this is my x-axis and y-axis. Okay, now curve is of this form, x is equal to 2a. Is there asymptote? This is 2a and x is equal to 2a. Is there asymptote? Okay, asymptote. And this is tangent, x-axis is tangent and y is strictly increasing in the interval 0, 2a. And this is my tangent, this is asymptote. Therefore, curve will be of this form. And since it is symmetric with respect to x-axis, taking reflection with respect to x-axis, we can plot this graph in this form. Okay. This is how we have to trace the curve. This is the graph of given curve. Okay. Now we come to second question. Now second question is y square a plus x is equal to x square into 3a minus x. We come to this question. Now this can be written as a y square plus x y square minus 3a x square plus x cube is equal to 0. Okay, first point is symmetry. Now this equation has even power of y, therefore symmetric about x axis. Okay, and everywhere power of x is not even, here it is 1, here it is 3, therefore not symmetric about y axis. Second is origin. On substituting x is equal to 0 and y is equal to 0, equation satisfies. Therefore, it passes through the origin. Passes through origin also. On substituting x is equal to y is equal to x and y equal to 0. We are getting identity. Therefore, passes through origin. Next, we have to find the tangent at the origin. Next, we will find the tangent at the origin. And tangent at the origin can be found by equating lowest degree terms to 0. Okay. Now tangent at origin. Tangent at origin is a y square minus 3 a x square is equal to 0. That is y square is equal to 3 x square. That is y is equal to plus minus root 3x. These are the two tangents at the origin. Next, we have to find the intersection with coordinate axis. Now, on taking x is equal to 0, this gives y square, a is equal to 0, that is y is equal to 0. Okay, and on taking y is equal to 0, we are getting x square into 3a minus x is equal to 0. This gives x is equal to 0 and x is equal to 3. Therefore, points of intersection are, intersection with coordinate axes are 0, 0 and 3a 0. Our points of intersection with coordinate axis. Okay, these are the two points of intersection with coordinate axis. Next, we have to find the equation of tangents at these two points. Now equation of tangent at 0, 0 is y is equal to plus minus root 3x. We have to find the tangent at the point this. Tangent at 3a 0. We have to find this. Now substituting x is equal to x plus 3a and y is equal to y plus 0 in the given equation. Okay. Then we have y square into a plus x plus 3a is equal to x plus 3a whole square into 3a minus x minus 3a. Okay. Now this is equal to, this implies y square into x plus 4a. This will get cancelled out. This is minus x, then plus x into x plus 3a whole square is equal to 0. That is xy square plus 4ay square plus x into x square plus 6ax plus 9a square is equal to 0. Now equation of tangent. Equation of tangent will be equating to 0, lowest degree term. Okay, equation of tangent will be, this is 3 degree, 2 degree, then again 3, 2, this will be 9a square, x is equal to 0. That is, x is equal to 0 or x is equal to 3a. This is the equation of tangent at the point 3a, 0. And equation of tangent at the point 0, 0 is y is equal to plus minus root 3x. Okay. Next, we have to find the asymptotes. Now, equation of asymptote parallel to y-axis will be obtained by equating to 0, highest coefficient of highest power of y. Okay. This is x plus a is equal to 0. That is x is equal to minus a. This is the asymptote parallel to y-axis. Okay. Now, equation can be rewritten as ay square plus xy square minus 3ax square plus x cube is equal to 0. Highest degree is 3. 3 here. Then 53m. Since highest degree is 3, 53m is obtained by taking y to be 1, y to be m and x to be 1. 1 into m square. And this 1, that is m square plus 1 is equal to 0. Okay, no real value, therefore no other asymptote. Therefore x is equal to minus a is the only asymptote, no other asymptote. Okay, next we have to find the region where our curve lies or where it doesn't lies. Okay, now y square is equal to x square into 3a minus x by a plus x. That means y is equal to plus minus x into square root of 3a minus x upon a plus x. Now y is defined as this. Now y will be real if this value is real. Therefore y is defined if 3a minus x by a plus x is greater than 0. Okay. Now we know quotient is positive if both numerator and denominator are positive, if both numerator and denominator are negative. Okay. This is possible if first 3a minus x and a plus x is positive, or both are negative, both numerator and denominator are negative, then also this value will be positive. Okay, now 1 gives, from 1 we get minus x is greater than minus 3a, and x is greater than minus a. Okay, x is greater than minus a, or this, that means x is less than 3a and x is greater than minus a. That is, x lies between minus a and 3a. This is one thing. Now come to the second part. Second part is 3a minus x is less than 0 and a plus x is less than 0. Okay. Now second condition gives us, now second gives both are negative. 3a minus x is less than 0 and a plus x is also less than 0. That is, minus x is less than minus 3a and x is less than minus a. That is, x is greater than 3a and x is less than minus a. Okay, that means no solution. Therefore curve lies in the region bounded by x is greater than minus a and x is less than 3a. Okay, this is the region where our curve will lie. X is greater than minus a and x is less than 3a. Next, we have to find the critical values. Where the function is increasing and where it is decreasing. Critical values. Okay. Next, we have to find the critical values. Now, y is equal to x into 3a minus x by a plus x power 1 by 2. We have to find the derivative. Okay. Now, this is equal to 3a minus x, a plus x power 1 by 2 into derivative of x is 1 plus x. Now, we have to find the derivative of this function. This is 1 by 2, 3a minus x, a plus x power minus 1 by 2 into, now applying the quotient rule, this is a plus x whole square into a plus x into this minus 1 minus 3a minus x into plus 1. Okay. Now this is equal to 3a minus x by a plus x by 2 into a plus x square root of a plus x by 3a minus x into this is minus a. This is minus a minus x minus 3a plus x by a plus x whole square. Okay, this is this. This x will get cancelled out. Now this is equal to 3a minus x by a plus x. This minus will get outside. This is minus 4a. Minus 4a 2 and here it is minus 4a. Therefore, this is equal to minus 2a x by 3a minus x and this is a plus x 2 minus this 1 by 2. I can write my equation in this form. This minus 2ax this, which can further be written as, which is equal to 3a minus x by a plus x minus 2ax divided by 3a minus x into a plus x power 3 by 2. Now this is equal to 3a minus x into a plus x power 3 by 2 into this is 3 root 3 multiplied, this is 3a minus x and this is 1 by 2 here, a plus x power 1 by 2 is here, left out is a plus x here minus 2ax. Okay, now on simplifying this we get 3a square plus 3ax minus ax minus x square minus 2ax by 3a minus x into a plus x power 3 by 2. Okay, now this is equal to 3a square. This is minus ax minus 2ax minus 3ax plus 3ax. This is equal to this. 3a minus x into a plus x power 3 by 2. Therefore, our dy by dx is equal to this. Now, dy by dx is equal to 0. If 3a square minus x square is equal to 0, that is x square is equal to 3a square. That is x is equal to plus minus root 3a. At this point, we have the maximum and the minimum value. Okay. Now, dy by dx is greater than 0. If this is greater than 0, if 3a square minus x square is greater than 0, that is 3a square is greater than x square. That is x square is less than 3a square. That is minus root 3a less than x less than root 3a. Okay. When x lies between minus root 3a and root 3a, then in that case our dy by dx is greater than 0. That means y is increasing in this interval. Okay. Now, this is therefore y is increasing. Therefore, y is increasing in minus root 3a and root 3a. But since our region is minus a 3a, therefore this is minus a minus this root 3a. Since our region is this minus a. Okay. Also, dy by dx is less than 0 if 3a square minus x square is less than 0, that is minus x square is less than minus 3a square, that is x square is greater than 3a square. Okay, that is x is less than minus root 3a and x is greater than root 3a. Then in this interval our y will be decreasing. Therefore, y is decreasing in this gives the interval minus infinity, minus root 3a, and this gives root 3a and infinity. That is in root 3a and 3a. These are the interval where our function is decreasing. Okay. Now let us plot the graph. These are the conditions where our function is increasing and where the function is decreasing. Okay, now let us plot the graph. Now this is my x-axis, this is my y-axis. Okay. And the points are first tangents y is equal to plus minus root 3x are the two tangents, and one tangent is x is equal to 3a. Okay, and the asymptote is these are the tangents and asymptote is x is equal to minus a, and x is equal to minus a is the asymptote. Okay. Let us first plot these. This is a, this is 2a, and this is 3a. Then root 3a. Root 3 is 1.732, will be somewhere here. Root 3a. Okay. Now x is equal to minus a. X is equal to minus a will be here. Okay. Now this is, let us draw this line as, this is my asymptote. X is equal to minus a. X is equal to minus a is one asymptote. Okay. Now x is equal to 3a is a tangent. x is equal to 3a is the tangent. This is the tangent. This is my asymptote. X is equal to minus a. And this is x is equal to 3a is the tangent. X is equal to 3a is the tangent. Okay. And the other tangents are y is equal to plus minus root 3x. Will be somewhere like this. Okay, this will be somewhere like this as tangent. Y is equal to plus minus root 3x will be like this only. Okay, now function is increasing in this interval minus a to root 3a. Okay, function is increasing in the interval minus a to root 3a. From here to here, my function is increasing. And after this, the function is decreasing. Okay. And these are this. Therefore, function will be of this form. Function is increasing like this. And these are the asymptotes. X is equal to minus a is asymptote. Okay. And up to here, it is increasing. Here, it is increasing. Up to this level, it is increasing. And after root 3a, function starts decreasing. Therefore, like this. Okay, now since it is symmetric about x-axis, taking its reflection about x-axis, we can plot the graph like this also. And same way like this here. So that x is equal to minus a is the tangent. Okay, now this is the graph of the given curve. Since it is increasing in the interval minus a to root 3a, it is increasing here like this and then it starts decreasing. And since it is symmetric with respect to x-axis, taking its reflection about the x-axis, the graph is of this form. This is how we have to trace a given curve. Okay, now that's it for the Cartesian curve tracing. In my next video, I'm going to discuss about the curve tracing when equation of curve is given in parametric form. Okay, if you have any queries or any suggestions, please write to me in the comment box. Thank you.